everyone, it's BTM-Kiwi back here again with another Forza Horizon 4 ForzaThon. So, for this week we need to own and drive any GT class car. We then need to gain a victory in two street scene events. We then need to earn 1 million skill score in our GT car and then a 15 mile drive, which will probably be around 24 kilometers, I think, maybe. My daily just earned 3 great wreckage skills. Our photo op challenge is any mini at Bamberg Castle. Our completion bonus is a Horizon backstage pass, I think, and then a Ford GT40, which is nice. No showcase remix and standard PR events. Any new cars? Nope, no new cars. Alright, let's take a look at our store and then get into it. Nothing particularly great in here, so I'm not gonna bother. So we want a GT car. That will probably be good, but for because I think the first thing is the street scene stuff. So I don't want something too extreme in terms of its rating. That's a GT car. Sure. I'm not quite sure how that has such great handling, but I'm gonna go with this. Yeah. Let's go with this. I don't know why that hasn't popped up yet, but alright. I want some quick street scene events. I want to have another quick look. I wonder if Super GTs count. Saw a GT. Because I was sure the Mercedes AMG GT, I think it's what it is, would count. So it's a bit odd. But well, I think it might be a Super GT, so I want to check. It probably is Super GT. Probably, yep. A GTS, GTR, definitely. Damn. Oh well. I guess I'll just have to see about maxing this out with when it comes to our skill score stuff. I need to think about putting the streamer mode on for audio. Oops, come on, stop doing that music. I always forget. Well, I forget often. Hoorah. Okay. Looks like I've done some recent setups for this. Well, that wasn't good. It was redlining for way too long. Oh, in that corner on the cobblestones, the cars just don't seem to brake too well on it. Even when I hit the brakes, when I'm told I should. I should probably stretch out those earlier gears. Ouch. Hey, one out of two done. Not too sure why. I guess it's because I'm not braking while I'm straight. I'm braking and then turning, so it's braking under turning and it just doesn't work too well. Another street scene, what's a nice short one? I know that there's a short one somewhere around here. Probably by the time I find it, would have been done by now. Oh, there's our super jump and our speed zone. At least we know where that is. I should just pick something. Just do this one. Even though I'm not too keen on the beginning of this one. Oh well. Fuck! Oh no, I'm stuck. Why the hell would they have something that stupid? I knew I shouldn't have picked this one. This one's so stupid. Car hits that little bald patch there on the road, and the rain makes it worse, and the car loses it. Very careful of that corner, because those little rocks that just passed will mess you up. They'll ruin your day. Great. An AI going right in the way at the very spot where I crashed, where I made very last time, and it almost forced me to make an error. By the looks of it, they got screwed up by that car as well, that my opponent AI. Right on a blind corner. This game really is stupid sometimes with where they spawn the AI. Alright, there's our two street scene events done. So it was a Jaguar CX-75 that was first. That's electric. No, that's not electric. I think it's hybrid. Can't remember properly. Alright, 1 million skills. Now, do I have a maxed out GT car? Let's... Nope. So these are the most I have. Don't really want to do much to that, but... I've already got this S1, so... Although that's meant to be a pretty good A-class car. So maybe I'll do something to the BMW. Nice, to be honest. Okay, let's bastardize it. Can engine swap. I can Change it to the Dodge V10, I think that is. Or maybe it's a BMW V10. So I know they make V10s. Even though that hand link didn't say it was too great, it felt pretty decent. On the front, 20 on the rear, that's fine. Some spacers. I clicked the wrong thing. So it's only got street tires. And I can't widen the tires either, so that's a bit odd. Jeez. This would make a decent bloody S1 class car, probably. Nice amount of power, nice torque. It won't even go up that high for what I need from it. Huh. Well, I did say I'd bastardize it, so let's try that. Because that's a bit underwhelming. Ooh, yeah. It's not too much better, to be honest, but I suppose it's over double the power, lighter, so it'll do. Three, 824, and this goes the same thing, so I can extend that out a bit more. Probably the 45 is fine. 783, 839. Alright. See if this changes much. Nope, no change there. Nope, okay. I'm gonna have that maxed and we'll see if this makes a change. Okay, change to the 160 plays. No change. And a change. So it looks like it was already on the best setting. Not that it really matters too much because I'm just doing this for the why is that so highly rated? So that's the actual safety car. The M package of the car. Yes, it's kind of cool, but let's go off this one. It doesn't matter. It'll be kind of ironic doing crashing and stuff with the safety car. Alright, let's get to it. Ooh. I should have actually checked the perk mastery stuff, because that's very important. Let's see if I can do that here. Yes, I can. Wreckage skills, drift tap, no skill score. Not the greatest, but it helps still. So it's the Lamborghini BTM. Or I should probably call it the Audi BTM. Not the, Jesus, interesting. So not the, the Dodge V10, which is what I was thinking it would be. But I suppose that's not 5.2 litres, is it? The Dodge V10 is a lot bigger. I think it's about 7 litres or something, 7.2 or something stupid. So I need 1 million skill score. We'll be right back. car that has the score multiplier builds twice as fast up, and it also goes to higher multiplications, or higher multipliers. I'm taking out way too many of these barriers. Not even a bloody half. I need to find a way to reset this area. So I'm at 500,000 skills per now. If I don't crash into anything. So taking it out as well. That was close, the train was coming. No! Oh, I couldn't see that because of all the bloody crap popping up on my screen. I hate doing this at night time. Well, that was a total waste of time. Teleport somewhere else and teleport back. And it didn't change at all the time of day. Really wish there was a way to skip the time. I guess for now, I'll do these PR events. hate these ones that have such high bloody skill score stuff and the car won't go that high. I should probably find a car that gives me a multiplier for more score. And I should probably just turn streamer mode off. Great. Thank you for being right in my line.
Turn around when it is safe to do so.
Stream is taking way longer than what I want it to. Hooray! What the hell's wrong with the fucking AI in this game? It keeps spawning all the bloody bullshit cars that just decide they don't want to race. So they're not getting out of the way fast. At least the rain stops.
Turn around.
And it's getting lighter, I think. Come on. Okay. Speed zones here. I will probably need an off-road car for that, definitely. Okay, I did that in the Toyota Baja. Where's our speed trap? Our speed trap is here. I need 249 for that. Are you kidding me? So many bloody bullshit cars in the way.
It's safe to do so. You've arrived at your destination.
So lucky those cars weren't on both sides. Alright, then we'll change to our Hoonigan RS 200, get this done, and then I'll go back to doing the ForzaThon weekly. And for some reason, it's not as bright here. Fast enough.
When it is safe to do so.
Only just, probably.
selected your destination.
Let's try that again. God damn it, that's so hilly and stupid. Even that part's ridiculous. I'm going too fast. Try getting it going this direction at least once. While I let the time go lighter. This car has a habit of just flicking to the opposite direction. Oh, even with this car, I've got a higher skill score rating than the bloody BMW. I slowed sat down so much because of all that bullshit, but I got a new personal best, so oh yeah! You guys saw how bad that was at the very end. I wish I could search my GT cars and check out their perks. Because I need to find one that has a skill multiplier. Because it's taking too long. It's irritating. Like these cars like this probably do, but I could always. Oh, can I actually check? And it's just viewing the car. It's got a nice rumble to it. You fucking idiot. They're so stupid. Alright. Ultimate skill chain scores increased. Extra influence. Record skills up. Score combo up. Near miss. Up. Side square, B drift and drift, lucky escape, instant wheel spin. Doesn't look like this one does the trick either. I guess I'll have a look at this BMW. I think this BMW is pretty good off the bat as well. Okay, that's got the Lamborghini V10 in it. Score combo, show off, ultimate skill. Okay, the score multiplier goes up. 3 times faster skill multiplier, cool. Alright, looks like I'm gonna use this. I don't know if I will max it per se, but I'll leave as is. Let's go do this. So I need 1 million skill score with a GT car, and suffer, but if my skill score does not go to 10, it will if I've got a skill song. Yeah, I definitely probably should have made this four-wheel drive. Now at time 7, I'm not sure how much I'll need to get to 1 million. I don't know what the hell happened there. But something happened and it just took away all of the... just despawned all of the bloody road open cords I needed. Just because of that random glitch. Right. Glitch has ruined it. I hate rear-wheel drive cars in this game. Because all this game is geared towards is drifting. I just want you to lose the back end to drift. It's so unrealistic how easily the cars just spin out all the time. How hard they are to maintain. I'm not sure how much I need to go to, but I think I had 820,000. So that's 60,000 times 7 should surely do it. Train coming. So I'm gonna leave it here and see what happens. And there we go. I just need a 24.1Ks. I'll change the car back to something faster. Oops. All right. Now let's get to the motorway, and then that's our stream done. Pardon me, if you guys heard that. So I was right, I think I said 24. Was a close call. Shit! Turn, you fat bastard. Come on. So I've gone back and forth once. I wonder when I'll get it. Should be getting it shortly. 24k is done. Oh shit. Take out the cows. Uh-oh. And there we go. And the new one just popped, but I'll do that another time, that new daily. Actually see what it was. All right, I'm pretty sure that's everything for this week. Oh, the photo challenger mini at Bamberg Castle. All right, let's get to it. And then that'll be our ForzaThon done. Let's do something different. Let's do this Rallycross. The Rallycross Mini. Jesus, nearly been an hour that I've done the stream for. Hate those skill score ones, they're stupid. And there we go. Thanks for tuning in, everyone. Hope you guys enjoyed it and found it helpful, even though it was annoying. But yeah, you guys know what to do, hit that follow button and subscribe if you want to see me do more stuff on Twitch, and I'll be exporting this to my YouTube channel too, so if you guys are interested in checking that out, you can follow the link underneath my live stream panel. Likewise, if you're watching this on my YouTube, then you can find the link to my Twitch on my channel banner. There should be a little link there, and likewise in the description of the video. As always, drop a comment on stuff you guys would like to see me do next, or things you think I could do better with, or just to pop in and say hey. And I hope you're all having a great day or great night wherever in the world you are. Peace out, everyone. Have a great one. And hope you're all keeping safe and healthy because of all this COVID shit still going on a year later after it started. So yeah. Peace out, everyone. Have a great one.